One of the root causes of the shortage of computer science graduates is simply the difference between what school students perceive computer science to be versus what a computer science graduate actually ends up doing. If you ask a school child what a computer scientist does, they might say fixing computers or maybe computer programming. But of course, computer science is a lot richer than that. The goal of the one-hour show that you're about to see is to convey to children exactly what a computer scientist does. We're not going to try and teach computer science, but we just want them to understand that it's a little bit more than writing software and playing with soldering irons. In the one-hour show that you're about to see, two computer science graduates are presenting ideas from computer science to children who are about 12 years old. We hope that you'll get ideas from this show for running your own presentations. Oh, by the way, it doesn't use computers at all. As Dykstra said, computer science is as much about computers as astronomy is about telescopes.
So all we've got to do now is wait for my faithful assistant, Harv, who is running late. So just wait patiently and we'll get things underway very shortly.
Matt.
Oh, hey, Harv.
Hey, me and Arnold, we're late.
No, that's good.
Are you setting up for the show?
Yeah, it's all set up.
Where are the computers?
What computers?
The computers for computer science?
We don't need computers to talk about computer science, Harv.
Arnold says you do.
Well, Harv, it's like this. Computer science, it's just science. Computers are just a tool.
But computer science?
Yeah, but it's like, I don't know, when you're looking at stars through a telescope, what do you call that?
Astronomy.
Astronomy, right?
Yeah.
It's not telescope science. Telescopes are a tool, and so are computers. And what we're looking at with computer science is information.
All right. Arnold still finds this hilarious.
Well, Arnold, would you like to see a trick? Who'd like to see a trick? Good, excellent. Okay,
Arnold, so, chill out.
Harv, I'm gonna need a volunteer for this trick.
A volunteer? I can totally choose a volunteer.
Yes.
Honey, what's your name?
Me.
Yes.
Brittany.
Brittany.
Brittany, good. Do you wanna come up here, Brittany? Do you guys wanna give her a hand? Nice.
Now, Brittany, so what you may or may not know is everything on a computer is stored using one of two numbers, right? Either 0 or 1. So what I've got here is some cards, and we're gonna use these cards to represent 0 or 1. Okay, so the black side is going to represent 0, and the white side is going to represent 1. Right. So what Harv started doing for you is we're putting up a grid of these cards. So I'd like a 5x5 grid, please. Now, I want you to put them up any way over you like. Don't make any patterns, because what I'm going to do is I'm going to try and memorize them.
Okay.
Okay? So I just want you to put up like that 5x5 grid of those black or white cards.
So it has to be like a square.
Like a square, yep.
I'm going to time you. With the power of my mind. There you go.
So while Brittany's doing that, we've got, what we've got is a bunch of zeros or ones. So does anyone know what a 0 or 1 is called on a computer? Yes.
Binary code?
Binary code, yes. So 0 and 1 are numbers, they're digits on a computer. So you guys are used to a different set of digits, the digits 0 to 9. But we use binary digits. So does anyone know the short name for a binary digit? Yes?
BD.
Not quite. I'll just do this. Yes, that's right. How are we going there, Brittany?
Okay. Brittany's running pretty well.
We're going pretty well?
She's faster than I ever could.
Okay, well that's... See, the thing with that is it's only 25 bits. So I'm going to make things a little bit harder. I'm going to add an extra row and an extra column.
You're crazy.
I'm going wild with excitement. Listen to the crowd, they're going mental.
And the crowd goes mild.
Oh. Yeah. Superb, okay. Just throw some of these extra bits on up there. Great, okay.
So what's the trick?
So, it's not really a trick, it's just science. But what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna turn around in a second and I'm gonna get Brittany to flip over one of those bits. Now, we've never met, have we, Brittany?
Nope.
There's no possible way that you could communicate to me which one of these bits you've flipped over. I'm relying on the power of my mind and the power of computer science.
Yep.
Okay? Yep. All right, so I'm going to turn around.
Don't let him fool you with his black magic, Brittany.
I'm going to cover my eyes. You guys are all going to watch me to make sure that I'm not looking. And you're going to watch Brittany to make sure that she's flipping a card. She's going to put a mark under the card that she's flipped over, just so that we know that I've got it right when I eventually do get it right using the power of science.
We accept.
All right, are you ready?
Yep.
Okay, good. Let's see. I'm going to guess that it is this one here.
Fluke.
All right, I'll do it again.
Do it again.
Okay.
Make it hard, Brittany. Oh God, not that one. No, God, anyone you want. Except that one. Stop it, do it.
Okay.
We accept.
All right, now there's 36 cards up here. There's a 1 in 36 chance that I'll get it right just by accident. And there's a 1 in whatever 36 times 36 chance is that I'll get it right twice in a row by accident. But I'm going to guess this one.
No!
All right, thanks, Brittany.
Brittany likes to giggle.
Yes, so that's my trick. So on with the show then.
How did you do that?
Well, I use science.
Lame.
You want to know the secret?
Yeah.
Well, sometimes scientists have to learn that there are some questions that they don't know the answers to. And it takes a long time before people can figure out those answers.
Whatever, you'll tell me later.
If you're good, I'll tell you at the end of the show.
Fine.
All right.
One of the key techniques is that we're trying to draw the answers out of the children. We're not trying to actually teach them the concepts, we just want to be able to give them confidence that they might have come up with the answers themselves. Now that we've looked at storing zeros and ones, well, so far it's just black and white cards, we're going to look at how we can group those zeros and ones together to represent data of various kinds, starting with binary numbers.